The other aspect to consider is water, because water is important, because of course the kale crop needs a lot of water to be able to grow. And here you can be able to explore a few aspects depending on the locality where you are. Starting with rain-fed as a water source, rain, that is as a water source, and this is mostly available in the highlands. You find that in high altitude areas, near forested areas, what we call the T-zones, you find that the rainfall there is reliable, and it's reliable throughout the year. And you can find that when you are growing the kale crop, you can be able to grow it throughout the year. So that becomes an advantage, because you are going to have your crop when there is high season, when there is low season, you're going to have your crop. If you don't have the advantage of the rains, especially in low altitude areas or medium altitude areas, when the rainfall is not reliable, what is advisable is you must have irrigation, a source of water, so that you can do irrigation, you can irrigate the kale crop. And here we are talking about having a water source, and the water source may be a dam, or it may be a river, it may be a spring, or maybe you maybe have a shallow well, or you may be having a borehole. And this kale crop, you can still do it under irrigation, under drip irrigation, and you can still pump water from the river, and then you irrigate your crop. Alternatively, you can still use the sprinkler irrigation, whereby you can pump water from the river, and then you have set your sprinkler irrigation in the farm, and then you can be able to irrigate your farm. And by so doing, you find that you can be able to time your crop, so that when the season is out, when it is a low season, and by low season it means when there is high supply in the market, because once it rains, then there is high supply of the vegetable, the kale crop, in the market, and that's the time you can plant another crop. But when it is dry, it means there will be low supply of kales in the market, because most of the farmers that are growing by a rain fed will not be growing. And by so doing, you find that there is a low supply of kale in the market. And by so doing, you are able to plant once you have irrigation, and you can be able to sell your crop, your kale crop, at a good price. And therefore, that is the other source that we are calling the irrigation, the irrigated water source. And another important aspect in water is about water quality. And the water quality is very important, because once you have a good water source, it means your crop is going to grow very well. And here we are talking about the water quality in terms of even the particles that this water contains, and even you may find the quality in terms of the purity of this water. And therefore, it is very important that the source, especially here you are talking about the irrigation source that you choose to be, a source that you can be able to be reliable. And on a general scale, we usually say if it is a water source that is used, and especially here we are talking about the towns. If maybe the water source, if it is a river, or maybe it's a dam and it is near towns or near urban centers, you may find there is a pollution that may take place that may cause the water not to be fit for even irrigation for crop. And therefore, if maybe it's not near maybe a pollution source, and this water is used for domestic animal, for drink by domestic animals, it is also used for domestic use in homes, it is clean, then you know, it is good water for irrigation. But in some areas when maybe there is a pollution, the water has been polluted, then that's when we advise you can go to a laboratory. There are people who do testing, water testing. They have labs that do water testing. You can get their services. They collect samples of the water. They do the testing of the water to see the purity of the water and maybe the chemicals that water may contain. And they can be able to advise you whether it is good water for irrigation or not. And once you have this water and now you have established your crop, then you are good to go. And you can be able to plant your kale crop to the land that you have prepared.